Philippine shares staged a recovery on Wednesday alongside most Asian markets as investors cheered reports China is ready to offer more support to industries to cope with the COVID-19 outbreak. The Chinese state media also reporting over 80% of China's state-owned enterprises, roughly 20,000 manufacturing subsidiaries, headed back to work. Goldman Sachs in a commentary says markets are right to rebound, but appear too optimistic about the upside. For the day, the PSE index added 74 points, or around 1%, to settle just a touch below 7,400.
So I think investors are quite jubilant that maybe COVID-19 have finally peaked, or maybe in the warmer months come March or April.
The problem is, as I've been highlighting in the past, markets like the Philippines, Thailand, and Indonesia are quite dependent on flows. And unfortunately, China accounts for a large part of emerging market baskets.
Metro Pacific Investments, through its unit Metro Vantage Properties, has signed a 1.6 billion peso hospitality and real estate venture with Thai-based Ducit International. This move comes as the Manny Pangilinan-led conglomerate grapples with regulatory risks for its other ventures, including Maynilad and Metro Pacific Tollways. On to another Manny, this time Villar, the Philippines' richest man, according to Forbes. His one-stop home improvement store, All Home, says it is on track to hit its 2020 store expansion program of over 450,000 square meters in selling space. The group also allaying fears the COVID-19 outbreak will disrupt importations, saying it has already secured inventory for its existing and new stores that will last for 6 to 8 months. And finally, Ayala-led Integrated Microelectronics reports a nearly $8 million in net losses for 2019. That's around 400 million pesos in losses as a slowdown in global markets continued to weigh on revenue, while investments in capacity and technical capabilities also increased overhead expenditures. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.